Our normal process for making videos is trial and error, testing some cheaper version of what you will be doing so that you can practice it and get a sense for it. But in slow motion, it's really hard to do that, especially when some of the elements are inherently dangerous. None of this stuff happens in our realm of experience, our realm of perception. They're not happening at speeds that we can access. So the only way that I can actually get in there and tinker with those events, the only way I can communicate with those events is through math. So I built this spreadsheet that had all the things we wanted to have happen.
And then all of the various parameters we needed to consider. The main ones are what time does it need to happen? So what time do I need to trigger it in some way? And what speed should the camera be going at that point? I guess we could look at the section where the balls drop and break. During that section, each one cracks right on a beat. We need to hit its podium and explode at exactly the right time.
So we've gone through the song and we've found the exact time for each beat we want to hit. We've got ball crash one at 1:48.387 seconds. And ball crash two is 1:49.354 and so on. So you get all the way up to 16. And now we also know that these are all evenly spaced notes, right? It's an even rhythm going dot, 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 dot. So if we compare the times here, we should find that the amount of time elapsed between each hit is the same. Sure enough, we see that each beat is, in fact, 0.967 seconds apart. Now for this video, our base frame rate is 30 frames per second. And what that means is that for each second of finished video, there are 30 still pictures that the camera is taking. So really, any duration of time can be thought of as actually a number of still pictures, right? And if we start at zero at the beginning of the video, each moment in the video has its own distinct picture number or frame number. So if we look back to the impact times, we can translate those into frame numbers. If we look at the duration of each beat, we can figure out how many frames each beat is. And so you see here, that's 29. So, okay, at this point, we have determined this much. Each beat of the song is 0.967 seconds long, and that'll be 29 frames of the finished video. That means each ball should land 29 frames after the last one, but the question really is, what does that mean for us when we're filming in real time? How much time do we need to wait between dropping each ball? Well, to capture slow motion, we'll be shooting with a really high-speed camera. It gets way more than the normal 30 frames per second. And in fact, you can see here that our frame rate at this point is 550 frames per second. We know we're trying to capture 29 frames, so if 1 second equals 550 frames, how many seconds equals 29 frames? X over 1 equals 29 over 550 equals 0.05272727277, repeating, which we rounded to 0.053. In real time, we need these balls to land 0.053 seconds apart. That's about a 20th of a second. Each of the balls was rigged at the same height above its platform, so that means each one will take the same amount of time to get to its impact. So now we know how quickly in succession we have to drop each one for them to land one beat apart in slow motion.
The dance we were trying to choreograph, all of these beautiful slow motion things, it's basically a giant math problem.
But you could also kind of see it as like a way of traveling, kind of, right? Because we never get to live at that time scale. We never get to see that stuff. And through math, we actually can kind of get these handles in a universe that we don't otherwise have access to. So it's also kind of like an insane sci-fi trip.